that he is 97 years old, it can be said that Bhalji Pendharkar's life has coincided with the story of the birth and growth of moving pictures. What manner of man was he? Is he? What were his life and his films about? For his lifelong contribution to cinema, he was given the Dada Saheb Phalke Award in 1991.
And now, the Dada Saheb Phalke Award for 1991 to Shri Bhalji Pendharkar.
Balchandra Gopal Pendharkar. His pioneering films like Bajirao Mastani and Bande Mataram Ashram, Bhalji set new standard of artistic excellence and gave inspiration to the freedom struggle. I have great pleasure that Sri Bhalji Pendharkar, the grand old man, being honored today by Rashtrapati ji with the Phalke Award this year.
He has sent a special word of thanks. I will read it out to you as he has sent it. With respectful adoration of Lord Krishna, Chhatrapati Sri Shivaji Maharaj and my motherland, I express my gratitude to the President and the distinguished audience present today. Filmmaking for me has always been a direct medium with quick appeal to mind. I used it for the cause of social uplift with the true belief in God, my country and religion. A lucky coincidence is that I was actively associated with the late Dada Saheb Phalke in his last film made in Kolhapur.
In a rare tribute, the minister came to Kolhapur to give the award to Bhalji Pendharkar.
When he first started, there was no talkie film. There are so many attractions for commercial life. But leaving aside all matters, he carried the flag of value-based film.
After some hesitation, reluctant as he was, the wishes of the audience made Bhalji Pendharkar speak.
छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज की जय, हिंदुस्तान की जय। मला आपण थोडस बोलावे अशी आज्ञा केली आहे आणि ते करणे माझं कर्तव्य समजतो, पण मनुष्य किती मोठा झाला त्या निसर्गापुढे त्याचं चालत नाही, मला बोलता येत नाही, आपल्याला सांगता येत नाही, पण ह्या अवस्थेत मी माझं वर्ग सोडावं असं मला कधी वाटत नाही.
When he was asked for his reaction, he said of course he was happy to receive the award, but in his own words, I am most happy because the people for whom I made films are happy today. This spontaneous appreciation indicates that Bhalji Pendharkar is more than a legend. He has for three generations lived in the hearts and minds of the people of Maharashtra. To examine this phenomenon, Films Division asked me to make a film on the life and work of the man, who incidentally is my father. During his long career, Bhalji worked with notable music directors, among them Sudhir Phadke, Vasant Desai, C. Ramachandra, Datta Dhauzekar, Hemant Kumar, and of course Lata Mangeshkar.
देना कभी पसंद नहीं था, लेकिन जब बाबा ने फिल्म शुरू की मोहित्यांची मंजुळा, तो हमेशा की तरह उन्होंने मुझे सब लिखे हुए गाने भेज दिए और मैंने पढ़े. एक गाना उसमें मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा, उसके बोल थे निया आभारी कातरवे. उसकी मैंने धुन बनाई और बाबा को फोन करके कहा कि अगर इस पिक्चर का म्यूजिक मैं करूं तो आपको कैसा लगता है, आपको विश्वास है कि मैं कर सकूंगी. उन्होंने कहा मुझे बहुत विश्वास है कि तुम बहुत अच्छा म्यूजिक करोगी और तुम शुरू करो अपना काम। और इसी तरह आनंद घन का जन्म हुआ। बाबा के साथ काम करना एक बड़ा सुंदर अनुभव है। एक गाना मैं बना रही थी तो न जाने क्यों मुझसे कोई अच्छी ट्यून ही नहीं बन रही थी। मैंने बहुत कोशिश की और बाबा को गाने की जरूरत थी जल्दी, तो मैंने बाबा को फोन किया और कहा कि बाबा इस गाने के बोल ऐसे हैं कि मुझसे इसकी ट्यून नहीं बन रही है। तो उन्होंने एक सेकंड रुक के कहा अच्छा अलग रखो वो गाना, मैं तुमको अभी बोल देता हूँ। और उन्होंने कहा देखो आयरणीचा देवा तुला ठिंगी ठिंगी वाहू दे कैसा लगता है। मैंने कहा बहुत सुंदर। मैंने उनको गा के बताया तो कहने लगे बहुत अच्छा है, अब तो तुम गाना बना सकती हो, लेकिन एक बात याद रखना ये गाना लोहार का है और वो दोनों मियाँ बीवी काम कर रहे हैं, तो इसमें मुझे भाती की और हथौड़े की आवाज चाहिए, भूलना नहीं।
Historical color film, Ganini Kawa. Now Bhalji is 83, his eyesight failing. He could see the source of light, but not the colors, not the composition of shots, not the expressions of each actor. But the actors who were working with him say that he could judge their facial expressions and movements by the tone of their voice. They were amazed. Chaturang, an association of young men, arranged a public meeting to facilitate Bhalji Bhandarkar. They presented him with the Jeevan Gaurav Award and a purse of 1 lakh rupees. It was an award not only for his work in cinema, but for his contribution to the social and cultural life of Maharashtra. While appreciating the touching gesture, he returned the money, saying that it should be used for needy and deserving people. It is the same with other honors conferred on him by people. Whenever he received cash, he returned it there and then for a good cause. This may be surprising for others, but not for us, the family. We knew his attitude towards money. After Gandhiji's assassination, his studio was burnt down by crowds in Kolhapur because of his association with the RSS and the Hindu Mahasabha. The average person would have given in to despair. But Bhalji said, I shall start a coal and firewood shop from the ruins and ashes and rebuild my studio. He did rebuild it. Dharma. Action. He was a karma yogi.
Jai Prabha Studio.
And of this institution and of Bhalji, the famous actress Salochana says,
Kareeban 50 saal pehle main yahan aayi. और सही अर्थ में यहीं से मेरा जीवन शुरू होता है। मैंने यहाँ अभिनय सीखा, उसके साथ साथ जीवन में कैसे जीना चाहिए ये भी मैंने यहाँ सीखा, क्योंकि ये मेरी पाठशाला है। मेरे गुरु बाबा यानी भालजी पेंढारकर जी, इन्होंने मेरे जैसे कई कलाकारों की जिंदगी पर्दे पर और वास्तव में भी यही बनाई है।
मुझे आज भी वो दिन की याद है, बाबा जी मुझे पनाह
लेकर चंद्रकांत
मंदिर में ले गए और कहने लगे यहाँ शिवाजी महाराज आया करते थे। वो मंदिर, वो वातावरण, वो भांजी के बोल, इन्होंने मुझ पर इतना असर कर दिया कि मैं चंद्रकांत नहीं रहा।
During the making of this documentary, in one of my visits to Kolhapur, I found these photographs on his table. I remember my photo with the stern Baba, and here was Baba, more than 50 years later, with one of his grandchildren. Has the man mellowed and softened with time? I wonder. Now, at the age of 97, this is his routine. At sunrise, prayer to the sun god, Surya Devta. Then on Tuesdays, he goes to a temple on the outskirts of Kolhapur, where he used to go with his mother, my grandmother of a century ago. I wonder what manner of man Bhaiji Pendharkar is. Dramatist, poet, director, moral philosopher, a revolutionary, yet an upholder of traditional values, a complex personality, but always his own man, uncompromisingly committed to his idea of the order of life. Then sometimes he goes to the studio. Why? A blind man with living memories, a director without vision. As it happens, it is not so. A few weeks ago he told me that he is writing a script for a new film. Well, not writing, but dictating. It is about a doctor and his wife who decide to give up the affluence of a city and go to a village to work for the underprivileged. Of course, I cannot direct it. But if you or any other director of your generation makes the film, I will be content. As his son, I wish Baba could direct it himself.